Thank you. Thank you. How's that? Let's see how that works. Monitor and output. Oh. That might help. OBS is picking it up at least. Okay, so by hitting enemies we ranked up Blunt Mastery from Novice to like F. So now we have 3 extra damage on each hit. And that's the sort of passive bonus each skill has. And there's a lot of skills. life skills, combat skills, magic, alchemy, martial arts, music, puppetry, gunslinging, ninja skills, chain blades, and some secret ones. So when the bar reaches 100, even if there's more possible experience to obtain, you can rank up the skill using AP. Wants us to normal attack, defend, and normal attack again. So by ranking of combat mastery to rank F, we get 10 HP and 1 strength. What defense does is it interrupts their combo and allows you to start your own. Gold, 1 dexterity, 1 strength, well, 30 AP. And we get up to Novice Warrior and Fledgling Knight, because we learned Smash, Counterattack, and Windmill. Against defense, we can use Smash. So let's see. Hit the rat twice. Smash immediately knocks down an enemy and bypasses the defense skill. So you might be able to see a sort of rock, paper, scissors happening or starting to form. But normal attack beats Smash. Yes. Counterattack beats both normal and smash, but you can't move. I think it constantly drains your stamina, and any area attack will still hit you. So, you want me to hit the snake, and use Windmill, which if you have a blunt weapon, is a breakdance. So what was I saying before? Every skill is a basically a hexadecimal value, ranging from novice, F to A, and then 9 to 1. You rank them up with AP after you gain enough experience by using it enough, or other training methods. So if I use defense enough, fill up the bar, and I can rank it up with some AP. For passive stats. And that's how you get stronger. Gold pouch. Because in this game, money takes up space. So he didn't actually explain Assault Slash, but what it does is when you knock down an enemy, you can attack them again with it to re-knock them down and close the gap. So that's pretty nice. Let's see if I can open up the world map. Here's Eula, and then Belvast, and Iria. So the giants live up here in the north because, yes, of course, and the elves live over here in the desert. Yeah, that's not quite Ulda, but it is close. So we start off in Tir Carmel. Then there's Dunbarton, Bangor, Imain Macha, Tal'tun, and Tara. Tara being the capital, so the castle's over here. The monarchy, and there's a lord in Imain Macha. I don't remember any other nobility. Okay, I will go gather an egg by touching the chicken. And there's even a skill associated with touching chickens. Which allows you to touch chickens faster. Oh, they gave me magic mastery too. Interesting. So we got holy water, which allows me to bless my items so they don't fall onto the floor when I die, and they lose durability slower. Probably one of the most important commodities in the game, so people really like the church part-time job. Magic stuff. These days, it's been like 10 minutes. Whatever. I'm sure you would like to know how magic works the most. Original Sin Staff. Ice bolts, charge up to 5, and just spend them. Okay. Lightning bolt, charges up to 5, does more damage the more charges you have, but spends all the charges at once to hit as many enemies as you have charges. Chain lightning. Firebolt spends all the charges on one enemy and knocks them down. And does more damage the more charges you have. Those are the basic spells. Now, advanced spells. We have Ice Spear, which freezes an enemy and causes them to explode, which will spread to nearby enemies, I think, if they die. And thunder. Let's see, what all did they give me? Thunder, Fireball, Blaze, Spell Lock, Snapcast. Is that it? Okay, no advanced magic. Just intermediate spell. Alright, so thunder hits multiple enemies several times. Fireball can only be cast with max charges. Takes a few seconds to travel, but hits a huge area with an explosion that knocks everything down. And then Blaze is a bit different. You hold it to charge, smack an enemy, they'll go flying, and then blow up a little bit. So there's three spells left that they don't tell you about here. There's Hailstorm, which causes you to stand in one place, you accumulate charges on your staff, and then you can just chuck out ice balls for as long as the spell lasts. I don't remember what the lightning one is. There's Meteor, which, well, calls down a giant meteor from the sky. And I think it's Chain Lightning. Mabinogi magic. Lightning Rod. Yeah, okay, yeah. You charge up and it's a giant laser in front of you. You might also like Hook Me. So, Alchemy. You have a cylinder strapped to your arm, and these consumable crystals. Wind, water, fire, ice. Wind, water, fire, wind, yes. Basic skill is Water Cannon, which looks a lot like Firebolt. Wind Blast is a short range knockback. Short range knockback with a cooldown. Sand Blast blinds enemies. And then Flame Burst. That's a flamethrower. Is that everything that they give you? Yeah, that's all they give you. There's more, but it gets more complicated. Okay, we'll show off Puppetry because it's fairly unique. Pull out my Piero. Now I control the marionette, not myself. It's a little weird. And just kinda hit stuff with the puppet. Okay. So with music, well, you become a battle bard. Bonk. And Discord is actually a dot, I think. Yeah. And then you have musical buffs. And we have lullaby, puts nearby enemies to sleep. Pretty useful. Not very strong. I'll let you decide what sort of character this will be for this playthrough. Whoa, why did you reset my Windows case? Thank you. Just says, hey, what's rebirthing? It's boring. Rebirthing, you reset your level, your age, possibly your appearance and gender. And you can switch talents. Now we can get the actual character creation with premium appearances. Can tell kind of how much better they've gotten with the newer hairstyles. Unfortunately, there's nothing like your pigtails in the front. So. Recommended. Oh. Well, I suppose that's close. Yeah. Let's see, sky green. That's probably close enough, right? Probably aquamarine or turquoise. Yeah, every single change changes the color of the clothing. And unfortunately, we can't get something called the premium noob wear anymore, which was like if you had premium appearances, you would get a fancier looking clothing. Let's go with this. So, okay, we can't pick a hero talent. Probably want to go with magic, am I right? Or magic or battle alchemy. Okay, yeah, there's lightning rod there. Hailstorm, fireball, enchantment. With battle alchemy, you've got Spark, Life Drain, Frozen Blast. You can dual wield cylinders. But I think there's a lot of skills you need from the story, so I think we'll go with magic. Today, that's great. I don't care. Receive equipment. Excellent. And it reset my window settings again. Stop it. They even give you a free ice wand. Okay, so if you... Yeah? Yeah, that's... Actually, pretty creepy. So if you see a book with the Star of David symbol on it here, that means when you read it, you will learn something. Like Ice Bolt. Really don't like their hotbar setup thing, because you have to use the function keys and then your number row here. After playing games like 14 for so long, Okay, there's some event stuff. Whatever. We don't need that anymore. Fortunately, since it's on my account, I can call my pets. Like this horse. And they can hold stuff for me. Yeah, don't listen to Fergus. Never repair him. Because he has a 90% chance per point to actually successfully repair it. And if he fails, it deletes that maximum point of durability. He is the worst blacksmith in the game. But you can get a title from him if you manage to completely break a weapon that is worth over 6,000 gold, I think. So that it becomes zero max durability in one transaction. Hey, you overwrote my spell. And yeah, you have to learn a skill in order to sit down. Set this over here. Some point that will start. So, there is glamour, but A, you need to have the item on you, and B, it costs money. But, that looks better. Okay. I forgot they give you a free horse now. Stronger you. So, let me see, what's my fastest pet? Probably one of these. So this is the Moon Gate. It's sort of the fast travel. Once you go somewhere, you touch the Moon Gate, and then you can go there at any point from another Moon Gate. Used to be, they were only active during the night, and they were on a cycle about which one they would take you to. So if you wanted to go to Seal Island, you had to wait until there was a Moon Gate going to Seal Island, and only for that night. Oh, yeah, they gave me a bag. Expands your inventory a little bit. So I could put like the Phoenix feathers and the potions in here, and then tag it with potion and say like scrolls and passes. So if I pick up any, they'll automatically go in here. Is there any? I'm just looking to see if there's any equipment that I could borrow. Well, there's a better ice wand. But instruments, pickaxe. Oh yeah, there's a lot of money in here. Well, if I need money, I got some. And holy water. There's a Trinity staff. Instruments. Recipes. Nothing in there. Not really. I know I have something. Beauty coupons. Explorer suit, more beauty coupons. Do I really not have any gear here? Okay. Let me go to Dumbarton. And Irea, the other continent, has mana tunnels, which used to only be available during the day, but worked like the moon gates do now. You can go to any one that you've been to. And they also have a side effect of rapidly restoring your MP. So let's see, there's... Oh god, there's so many people here! Yeah, I don't think I've ever used an altar of restoration. There she is, Avon. It just talks about the dungeon guide, which is this thing. And it goes like, hey, here's how you could reasonably progress through the dungeons. But since Albi Dungeon is full of giant spiders, I think I can wait on that. Although that's gonna be part of the missing townsfolk thing, so I'll have to do it eventually. There are so many people here. I don't know when they added this, but it's basically just, hey, here's rapid transportation to any dungeon in the game. Remnant of the first battle of Mount Turad. I don't know. Ten pieces of paper. Do I look like I have paper on me? Yep. Well, it's 10 gold. Pieces of paper were used. Do what now? Talk to the archaeologist. Okay. And then I need to go toward a Helvy dungeon. Firebolg. Okay. You should dismount before approaching. You approach the rock. You want to go to Albi Dungeon. Well, I don't want to go inside, but that's fine. I don't mind dungeons, but spiders I could pass. Fortunately, I do have to go through the dungeon with spiders in it. Is it, do you mean like it hurts because it's low poly, or because there's so much blue? But yeah, I can see that. I don't mind it so much because I'm used to it. Alright, here's your warning. There's going to be spiders here. Thankfully, it's not a very long dungeon. Oh, there's rats, too. Enable pet auto finish somewhere. Summons finish automatically? That might be it. I know how to use dungeons. Okay. That should be all the spiders for now. Speak to Trevor. Okay, I need to take that off. Dunbarton again. Oh, you can't teleport while mounted. Okay. I should check to see if I have to change channels / relog in order to get the story cutscenes started. Let's see. Generation 1. Elves and Giants receive cutscene after... Okay, so I might have to switch channels. Change channel to channel 5, sure. Nope, okay. Well, it'll be there at some point. Promise. Okay, where's this? This is the chapter 6 quest, so I'm gonna not with that. Speedbar potion. Thank you. Here is your mission. Okay, so this is the Shadow Mission tutorial. They go, hey! Go into the Shadow Realm for a loot. You've entered the Shadow Realm. What the hell? So this is just the DevCat logo as an NPC, so it's a developer stand-in. Kind of like the Wandering Minstrel with Yoshi P. Oh, hi. I learned to critical hit. Because you actually have to learn how to do critical hits. Learn his loot. Now we exit the Shadow Mission and go back to Hadan. To Lorna. heal level 50. This is an Arat berry. Okay. Before I go further, I want to see if actually relogging works. Nope, okay. So it's just gotta wait for it, I guess. Let's go to Andras. That it. All right. So many people. I did fly. Comrades in arms. Speak with Aran. How to form a party and all that. And we should be done with Lorna and Pan for now, maybe? Gold pouch. And a balloon. strange signs. Okay. Oh, that's right. I forgot you can fly in Yulav now. Not just the Chapter 3 areas. I'm so used to it being like old A Realm Reborn where you couldn't fly. Oh, I didn't want to do Sense of Loss. Alright, whatever. We'll pretend that didn't happen. Alright, that. Okay, now we start Chapter 1. Advent of the Goddess. Right. You go to the snowy hills of Shisnikta. Wait, what is it? Ma, it's that weird cat again. So, they didn't used to tell you which snowman you had to hit for the earring. But now it glows, it has a quest marker. You used to have to notice that every snowman here has 14 teeth. Except for this one. Which, oh no, wait. Okay, well he's supposed to have 16 teeth. And that's how you know. And the teeth glow at night, which was another hint. I guess they swapped out the model at some point. Because he's supposed to have 16. That's disappointing. They didn't even used to give you mana herbs before. They just said, hey, this bear likes mana herbs. I think I have to wait till daytime for this, though. Yeah, deliver 5 mana herbs. You used to have to, like, gift them one by one to the bear. And so you got a specific line of dialogue that says the bear is writing a name in the snow. Tarlac. I do not really miss how it used to be, but I appreciate what they were going for. You must enter during day. Yeah. It gives you 8. Yeah. Sometimes I feel old. Back in my day. Yeah, we'll eat the bread while we're waiting. We could probably use this homestead ticket. Create a homestead. The homestead is basically a Facebook game. Does he even give you a pickaxe? Okay. They do give you a pickaxe. Where's the build menu? Gotta create a camp. Homestead expanded. Okay. And then you need a farmland to plant the seeds. That, plant the strawberries, and then leave. No, it's daytime. Oh, look, a bear. Just standing here at an altar. The bear writes Tarlac in the snow. Yeah. You used to have to, like, pick up one and give it to the bear like that, like, 5 times. Very tedious. I go back to Duncan. Donuts. Oh, and they put a moon gate here after like a few years. Okay, if you were actually riding a broom like this, you would fall off. Okay. We'll talk to Stuart. How can I help? So, I'm not saying that Square Enix copied this game, but this is the first instance I even know of the roleplay dungeon, where, kind of like in 4.4, you play as the NPCs. Let's see, probably want to buy Firebolt, and healing, lightning bolt. Meditation, I don't really care about. But the rest are nice to have. And firebolt, and healing, and lightning bolt. The Elemental Apprentice title. Very nice. Can red wing over to Alpi Dungeon real quick. And use the locket on the altar. Rory, Mary, and Tarlac. And if you're alone, you'll play as Rory, who has a blunt weapon broadsword, a ton of potions and firewood, and some studded Oregon leather armor. If you go with three people, I think the party leader is Tarlak, second person is Rory, and the third person is Barry. I didn't set his skills. Smash. It's pretty much just a regular dungeon, but with a couple cutscenes in it. What sort of surprise do you have for me, Shola? Okay, so that's the RP dungeon. Let's talk to Duncan. Sure. This was my original character, who has gone through a lot of changes over the past, when did I start playing? Like 2008? So 13 years? Elf Alt. The giant, who has also gone through a lot of changes. My new main character, who I made before Shadowbringers, like the spring before Shadowbringers, and quickly got on par with and passed my original character, and an alt that I made that I'm deleting, and then Hidiot. Because I used what is known in the community as a flashy dye, which means it cycles through several colors. So here I've got several flashy blue dyes on the outfit. Now if I view all, then it shows all my pets too. I've got a few pets. Alright, expired. Rental pets can be deleted. So yeah, I don't have pets show up on favorites for a reason. And then there's two classic character cards. Oh, I could have gotten those for free. Whoops. Oh. Mentioned every day has different passive effects based on what festival the day represents in the wheel of the year in Druidic tradition. So Saturday is Samhain, Halloween, basically, and that's when you age up and can explore area a little easier. fifth. They're gonna make me do Sense of Loss. I don't want to. Go to She Snicked at Night. And now I have two copies of the same book. And I don't feel like reading it, but it explains what the statue is in every dungeon. Didn't I say it? They're really gonna make me do Sense of Loss. Ooh. An elf? Now that we can come here at night, we will see shortly. That the bear was only pretending. Surprise! It's Tarlac. What's next? Is it the Dunbarton Bookstore? Eternity. Alright, so this part here, you used to have to wait until midnight Pacific time in order to advance. Like, she would make you wait an hour, and then say, sorry, it's still not ready yet. And you have to wait till the next day. Actually, it might not have even been midnight. It might have been 7 a.m. Which was the reset time. In order to get this book. It was, very dumb. But now it's a little faster. All right. Talked about wrong one for this. And for starting that quest, we get some better armor. So if I take the style clothes off, graceful plate armor. Not bad. And a broadsword. So to progress, we have to read this book, which explains what Tirnanog is, means, what paradise is, and a whole bunch of other stuff. And now we gotta go back to Tarvac. After we read the book, we're like, hey, paradise doesn't sound so bad, what are you talking about? A brown Fomor pass to Barry Dungeon and a red wing. But instead, I'm going to take the book. So I can save the wing for later, just in case. Welcome to Banger. The third of the three towns the game started with. We only had this little straight line. And we have Barry Brown Fomor Dungeon. Which I think used to be three floors. Maybe it's now one floor? I don't remember. They did shorten it. King Mimic, huh? Fairy Dungeon is where you mine ore for refining into metals and blacksmithing and all that. Used to be the only place you could do that. And then they added Area, which had other areas to mine ore. And then, oh Jesus. Swords are a bit hard. What is that? And then they added metallurgy, which lets you gather ores on the beach. So that's pretty nice. Oh, hi. That skull mark was the deadly status, which means the next hit will kill you because you're at negative HP. Flying swords. I forgot that they did that. They level up. And they get bigger. Okay, yeah, they did shorten this dungeon. Scrolls in here. I'm just gonna open that last door. This guy seems friendly. Alright, so we got a couple rank ups to do. There used to be a lot more in the boss room here. Now it's just a few wisps and the wizard himself. Wisps are a little unique. They tell you what they're going to use by the punctuation that they use as a chat thing. So in the reward chest we get this medal, which looks a lot like a priest token. Strange. Well, let's talk to some priests then. Actually, I think they just want you to talk to one in particular. Or maybe you have to use the keyword first. Nope. Okay, never mind. To Dunbar. I think you used to have to just talk with the keyword every single priest character. So that was Comgan, Crystal, and Delian, and then Mevin. Probably gonna make me deliver the package first. She knows more than she is letting on. Material and the weight are different. Alright, so Reynold knows somebody that knows how to read it, I guess? Ronald? I need to say Ronald. It's Ronald. Says go to Albi Dungeon Arena, which was actually a pretty fun thing back in the day, because it's just PvP with no real rewards. One of these coins that he gave me. That'll be Battle Arena. So there's rounds, you earn stars by killing people, and you get coins based on how many stars you have. Buy more supplies. So that's the original PvP thing. And then we need to talk to Tarlac, which means probably gonna have to wait a little bit. You just wait for the bear. Let's bless some other stuff while we wait. Organize my inventory a little bit. Where did those go? Oh, it's the VIP tab. Okay. I was like, what? Alright. I missed that I got more than just the armor and the sword. Yes, I read you. Take off the style stuff, it's not too bad. I like the Tarch shield. I think it used to be only from Gacha. I don't remember. is what I figured you might feel. Certainly, in this decade, I don't expect anybody to like playing the game. I like this mount. Though there is also more than combat, in case you happen to like the life skills. Let's see, what have we got? Commerce, production, I don't know what that is. Fishing, crafting, winemaking. There's a lot of new ones that I've not seen before. Magic crafting. There's a lot. We should be about ready for nighttime. Oh, that's right. Here. Nope, come on. I'm gonna save that for later. Arena. Togoro, he has terrible translation skills. What? I wonder. Rabby Dungeon Lobby. So another RP dungeon. This time we get to play as Tarlag. So let's see, what skills do we got? Defense, and Discord, and some high ranked magic. Mm-hmm. think this used to be a full 3-floor dungeon too. And they shortened it. Oh my god, I just die already. Jeez, Torlek, just ask her out already. It's been 5 times. And it reset the window settings again. Sheesh. Thank you. Sheesh. How not to talk to women. Hey, I know you thought I've been dead for the past, I don't know, 10 years. Can you translate this book for me real quick? So that takes a little bit. I think that used to take an hour. To the homestead. Harvest the strawberries. So homesteads are really nice for like having a ton of gatherable materials in one spot, like herbs and livestock. But it takes a while to get there. Fill off some of this extra stuff. Can't sell that, okay. Oh, now Blondie shows up. Okay. Familiar voice, okay. So this character is basically the catch-up mechanic for new players or returning players. She will fast-track you to total level 5,000. And by fast-track, I mean really fast. As well as, teach or remind people about other features of the game. So I'm not gonna do that just yet. Yeah, we learn about each other for the first time in years, and he asks me to translate a book? Unfortunately, it is now daytime, which means I cannot talk to Tarlac. So, probably stop here for today, and then we'll come back tomorrow or Sunday, keep going.